Hello students, welcome back. So in the previous class we had completed exercise 2.1. Now we'll move ahead towards 2.2. Here in this, what it is there, you are having the word problems. Now in word problems, what you have to do is you have to first create the linear equation and then you have to solve it. So solving the linear equation, I have already explained you. Now we will just straight away move towards the questions. I'll read the question and I help you out in making the equations and then we will solve them. So here the first question says, if you subtract 1 upon 2 from a number and multiply the result by 1 upon 2, you get 1 upon 8. What is the number? Now here what it says, you have to find the number. So this is unknown to us. This value is not known. So what we will do? We will take it as a variable. Let the number equals to x. Let the number equal to x. Now if you take the number as x, now according to the question, according to the statement, what we have? If you subtract 1 upon 2 from a number, so the number which we have taken is x. Now from this x, we have to subtract 1 upon 2. So if you subtract 1 upon 2, you get x minus 1 upon 2. This is what you will have. And multiply the result by 1 upon 2. Now after subtracting, this is the result which we have. Now this result is to be multiplied by 1 upon 2. And when you multiply it by 1 upon 2, you get 1 upon 8. Getting 1 upon 8 means it is equal to 1 upon 8. So this is the equation which we have. And now this equation we have to solve. So solving this equation, what we will do is at first, this multiply 1 upon 2, this 1 upon 2 is being multiplied by whole, that is x minus 1 upon 2. So this number we will transpose it to the second side, to the right hand side, that is multiply 1 upon 2 will become divide 1 upon 2. So you have here x minus 1 upon 2 equals to 1 upon 8. Now multiply 1 upon 2, when you take it to the other side, it will be divided by 1 upon 2. So you can at first write it like this, divide 1 upon 2. And this will become x minus 1 upon 2 equals to 1 upon 8 multiply, because divide we will convert it into multiply and we will take the reciprocal of 1 upon 2. Taking the reciprocal means it will be inverted, it will become 2 upon 1. So here now you can simplify this. Now this step which I am writing here, the second step which is written, this you can eliminate it. You can even leave off this step. You can straight away multiply 1 upon 2, move to the other side. You can make it as 2 upon 1. So this you get x minus 1 upon 2 equals to, after simplifying what you have here, you have 1 upon 4. Now minus 1 upon 2, it will move to the other side and this minus 1 upon 2 will be written as plus 1 upon 2. So you have 1 upon 4 plus 1 upon 2. Now you solve this. They both are fractions. So adding the fractions, you need to take the LCM. So LCM of 4 and 2 is 4. 4 divided by 4 is 1 and 1 multiplied by 1 will give you 1 plus 4 divided by 2 is 2, multiply 1, it is 2. So you get x equals to 3 upon 4. So this is the value of x which you get. And what was x taken? X was taken the number. And you had been asked that what is the number? So at the last you write down there, therefore the number is 3 upon 4. This is your final result. Now if you just want to cross check it, whether your answer is right or wrong, in that case what you will do, you will make the same statement, make the same equation, but with this number now. So if you subtract 1 upon 2 from a number, so number is 3 upon 4. So 3 upon 4 minus 1 upon 2 and multiply the result by 1 upon 2. Now this result, you will multiply it by 1 upon 2. And the question says you get 1 upon 2. So you will just simplify this, cross check whether you are getting 1 upon 8 or not. So if you do this, 3 upon 4 minus 1 upon 2, you will subtract it by taking the LCM. 4 is the LCM. So you have here 3 minus 2 and multiply 1 upon 2. Now 3 minus 2 upon 4, this is 1 upon 4. And 1 upon 4, when it is multiplied by 1 upon 2, it gives you 1 upon 8. So we are getting the same thing what is given in the question. So this makes that our solution, the number which we have found, is right. Now we will move towards the second question. Now second question says, the perimeter of a rectangular swimming pool is 154 meter. You are having a rectangular swimming pool and it is given that the perimeter is 154 meter. Its length is 2 meter more than twice its breadth. Now what is given? You are given that the length of the pool is 2 meter more. 2 meter more means extra 2 meter is being there. 2 is added to what? Twice its breadth. Double of the breadth. You have to tell what are the length and the breadth of the pool. So suppose if you are having a swimming pool which is rectangular form, say this is the pool. Now this is length and this is breadth. Here now what is given to us, first thing which is given is perimeter of pool is 154 meter. We are given that the perimeter of the pool is 154 meter. Then the length is 2 meter more than twice its breadth. Now here the length is compared with breadth. So what we will do is we will take the breadth of pool, say x meter. We will take the breadth as x. Now if you take the breadth as x, then length of pool. Now what will be the length of pool? The length is 2 meter more than twice its breadth. So first you are going to take twice its breadth, double of the breadth, and then you are going to take 2 meter more. So double of the breadth means 2x, and 2 meter more, it will be plus 2. So the length is 2x plus 2 meter. So if you are taking x as the breadth, the length becomes 2x plus 2. Now what is the perimeter of a rectangle? You have been studying this. So perimeter of rectangle, we know that it is given by twice L into L plus B, twice the sum of length plus breadth. 2L plus B is the perimeter of the rectangle. So this 2 multiply L. Now what is L here? The length, it is 2x plus 2 plus breadth, that is x, equals to the perimeter, that is 154. So this is the equation which you get. Now from this equation, you have to simplify the things. So this will be 2 multiply. Now in the bracket, it is 2x plus x. So it gives you 3x plus 2 equals to 154. Now here, you can do it in two ways. Either this 2, which is being multiplied whole by 3x plus 2. What we will do is, we will subtract, move this 2 to the other side. So what you get? You get it as 3x plus 2 equals to 154. Now this 2 is being multiplied. It is multiply here. So on the other side it will be divided. So you will divide it by 2. So this becomes 3x plus 2 equals to 77. Now you can solve this. Plus 2 will be taken to the other side. So 3x equals to 77 minus 2. Plus 2 will become minus on the other side. So 3x equals to 75. And if 3x is 75, then x equals to 75 divided by 3. That is 25. We get the value of x as 25. Now the second method which you can do here is taking this 2 multiply 3x plus 2 equals to 154. What you can do here, you will first simplify the bracket, solve the bracket this. So that 2 outside the bracket will be multiplied inside with both the terms. So 2 multiply 3x will give you 6x and 2 multiply 2 will give you 4. So it is equal to 154. Now this 6x equals to 154 minus 4. So 6x equals to 150 and x is equal to 150 divided by 6. And 150 divided by 6, that is also 25. So we get the same value of x for both the sides. Now what is the question? We have to find both the length and breadth. So x is 25 and what was x taken? X is taken as the breadth of the pool. So therefore, breadth of pool is equal to 25 meter and the length of pool. Now what is length of the pool? The length of the pool is 2x plus 2. This is what we had created, 2x plus 2. So it means 2 multiply 25 plus 2. So this is 50 plus 2 and it is equal to 52 meters. So this is the length of the pool. So breadth of the pool is 25 and length of the pool is 52 meters. So this is what we had to calculate. Hope this question is clear to you. Now let's move towards the next question. Question number 3. Now question 3 says, the base of an isosceles triangle is 4 upon 3 centimeter. Now you have an isosceles triangle. You know what is an isosceles triangle? The isosceles triangle is a triangle in which two sides are equal. So if suppose you take these two sides equal, then this is the third side is known as the base of the triangle. So here the base of an isosceles triangle is 4 upon 3 centimeters. So this base is 4 upon 3 centimeter. The perimeter of the triangle is 4, 2 upon 15 centimeter. Now what is perimeter of a triangle? Perimeter of a triangle is sum of all the three sides. So what is the length of either of the remaining equal sides? So what you have to find out? You have to find the length of either of the remaining equal sides. Means the remaining two equal sides are there. You have to tell the length of each of the side. So because both are equal, if you take one side as x, the other side will also be taken as x. So the solution of this question, let each remaining sides, or say let each equal sides measure x centimeter. We are taking it in centimeters because the side which is given, that is also in centimeter, the perimeter which is given, that is also in centimeter. So we take the equal side each as x. So both the sides will become x. Now you are given perimeter of triangle. Perimeter of triangle we are given as 4 × 2/15 cm. Now what is perimeter of a triangle? The perimeter of a triangle is equal to sum of three sides. The triangle perimeter is sum of three sides. Now if you are taking the sum of three sides, what are the three sides? One is x, second is x, and third is 4/3. So sum of these three is equal to 4 × 2/15. Now if you do this, x plus x is 2x equals to 4 × 2/15 − 4/3. This plus 4/3, we take it to the other side and it becomes −4/3. Now in this case, what we will do now? We will simplify this, and to simplify this, you see here 4 × 2/15 is a mixed fraction. So first we will convert it into improper fraction. So 15 4 times. 15 4 times is 60. 60 plus 2, 62. So you have it 62/15 − 4/3. Now this is what you have to simplify. So 2x equals to, again being fractions, you will take the LCM to simplify them. So LCM of 15 and 3 is 15. So 15 divided by 15 is 1. 1 multiply 62 will be 62 minus 15 divided by 3. 3 5 times is 15, and 5 multiply 4 is 20. So what do you get here ultimately? You get 2x equals to, now 62 minus 20 is 42/15. Now next step, what will be there? What we will do? We will shift this 2 to the other side. 2x means it is 2 multiply x. So x on the other side will be divided, 2 on the other side will be divided, and you get 42/15 × 1/2. Now this you can simplify it. 42 and 2, when you simplify, you get 21/15. 21 is there, and this 21/15 you can further simplify. And when you further simplify, 3 7 times is 21 and 3 5 times is 15. So you get 7/5. And 7/5, what type of fraction it is? It is an improper fraction, because numerator is greater. So it is an improper fraction, and improper fraction you can convert it into mixed fraction. So we will divide 7/5. 5 1 times is 5, and 7 minus 5 gives you 2. The remainder is 2. So 1/2. This is the value of x. And what is x? X is the measure of each equal side. Therefore, length of each equal sides is equal to 1/2 cm. So this is the result. Hope the question is clear. So today we are doing up to question 3 only, and those who are having the books, at least try out the next 2 more questions. We'll discuss this in the later video. Till then, have a nice day. Thank you all. Jai Hind.